Hello, Internet. If you are new to my blog, to my webpage, welcome. If you're not, thanks for coming back. As you can see, I'm not in the traditional writing form right now. School has got me kind of typed out since everything is online and we're doing lots of papers and discussion posts and whatnot. So my dad told me that it was time to update my blog because I haven't done one in a while. So I figured, hey, I'll try my hand at a video blog. So welcome. I hope that you get a little something out of this. I'll try not to make it too long or ramble too much. So one of the things that's really been on my mind lately is choices. And you know, that's something that you have probably heard a ton about is choices and the choices that we make and what is coming up with the election and all of that stuff. And I promise you I'm going to try not to get too political, but it is important that you vote. That is your civic duty as an American, if you're watching this in America. And I hope that you all get out and vote and do your due diligence, because you need to. It's a good thing to do. But yeah, choices. And choices are something that face us every day. Every morning when we wake up, when that alarm goes off, the first thing we do is make a choice. Do we snooze it or do we get up? And for me, it's usually snoozing it and waiting for the second or third ring, and then I get up. But there's, you know, folks out there that, you know, it rings the first time and they get up. And I applaud those people because I'm not one of them. But yeah, so our mornings are from the time that we become conscious again, we start making choices. And these choices just continue to roll as our day goes through. You know, do I eat breakfast? Do I turn the TV on? If I turn the TV on, what am I going to watch? If I eat breakfast, what am I going to eat for breakfast? You know, for me, it's I have three leashes hanging outside my door to walk my dog. Which leash am I going to put on his collar as I walk? And it's just, it's choice after choice after choice. And it really is a snowball effect on how our lives work. And oftentimes, and I'm speaking from my experience, the choices I make centered around me. And I make them not looking more than 6 inches in front of my nose. And I had a conversation with a friend the other day because we were talking about, you know, voting and who we thought should be elected. And I'm not going to tell anybody who they need to vote for. I want to make that very clear. You vote for who you want to vote for. But I had expressed who I was thinking about voting for. Well, you know, which party they came from and whatnot. And didn't necessarily try to dissuade me, my friend. But she did raise some points. And some of those points were just thinking much bigger than I was thinking. And while I was, you know, in who I was wanting to vote for, thinking relatively big, at least in my mind, I think that the end check mark was coming down to me. Was where do I want to put this check mark? Instead of thinking, if I put this check mark, what all is it going to do? Not only to me, but to everybody else around me. And, you know, thinking of that, it goes back to that biblical narrative of love your neighbor as yourself. Well, to love yourself, to make those decisions about yourself, you need to be able to love your neighbor. And if you are doing an election, you know, And you're voting just for yourself. Are you loving your neighbor at that point? You know, and this isn't anything about how much money you make or what race your neighbor is or whatever it is. It is simply when you make a choice, do you think how this affects other people? And you know, we make choices every day, you know, and I know I've already said that, but you know, an example that's not political, because you know, you can't really have those nowadays, can you? Everything has to be political. But an example is, you know, you invite folks over for dinner. How spicy are you gonna make the food? That's gonna affect a lot of people. If you're inviting 10 people over and, you know, eight of those people don't really like spice, ain't nobody gonna eat your food. And so I think, you know, that's a really bare way of looking at it, but it's true. That choice that you made to put that extra teaspoon of cayenne pepper into your pot of chili, that's gonna affect anybody that eats that chili. But it's the same thing. Every, you know, when driving a car, for example, you know, somebody, a buddy of mine told me one time, it's like, it's the most unlogical thing you can think of if you actually think about it. You're driving 70 miles an hour, 6 inches a foot away from somebody, driving also 70 miles an hour. And it's a complete stranger. But the choices that you're making right then to stay in your lane, to use your blinker, to slow down or speed up, those choices have massive impacts on the people around you. And so it is the same thing when we choose to act, to do anything in this life. And one of our readings for this week in one of the classes that I'm taking, it's all about the way in which the global context of Christianity is looking nowadays. But there's a line in it, and it's talking about Christian theology. And it is talking about Christian theology not just as something that is in our heads, but as the way in which we are acting. And that really struck me because oftentimes whenever I hear the word theology, for me, it is this headspace kind of thing. Let's talk about all of this crazy, mysterious, divine stuff that is so hard to grasp, to get any kind of tangible thing to. But if we take our theology and we move that theology into the real world. If we look at, if our theology is that God wants to have a relationship with us, that God loves us, gives us grace, mercy, all of those things, then if we're living that out, if we're living that theology out, that's a completely different impact on the world than if we're just leaving that theology in our headspace. And so it's the choices that we make that really are going to define what, when we leave this earth, people are left with. Or how we act in this world is really going to define how people see us, even now. I mean, me choosing to put out this video may affect a lot of people. I don't know. It may only get 3 views. Again, I don't know. Who knows? But it's a choice that I'm making. But it's a choice where I'm having to sit here and I got to think about my words. Because if I say the wrong thing, I mean, I may lead somebody down a wrong path. You may lead somebody down a wrong path. You may hurt somebody. And yes, sticks and stones may break your bones, but words will never hurt you. But that's not a reality. Reality is, yeah, sticks and stones will break your bones, but words will cut you pretty deep. And sometimes it's the lack of words. Sometimes it's the choice not to speak that is going to hurt. You know, that's something that I've regretted being here in seminary, is there's been conversations where I haven't spoken up. And I have those conversations in my head. I don't know if anybody else does. But, you know, you go through those conversations, you know, oh, I could have said X, Y, and Z, and then maybe the conversation would have gone here, and then it would have gone over here, and then I could have said this, and brought it back to this. And, you know, you just go through all the conversations in your head, but you made the choice not to say anything. And you got to live with that choice. And you never know what those words could have changed. Maybe it had changed the whole, for me, you know, maybe it had changed the whole dynamic of the class. Maybe I'd have liked the class a whole lot more. Maybe I'd have gotten a whole different perspective from the class if I'd have spoken up. Who knows? You don't know, because you made a choice. I made a choice. I made the choice not to speak. Or you made a choice not to speak. Or you made a choice to speak. It's the choices that we make in this world matter. And there's so many choices that are so apparent nowadays. The election coming up. The election now. I'm not even going to say it's coming up. It's right now. You can early vote now. If you're voting absentee, you can send your absentee ballot in now. The current choice that we're making for the leader of our country here in the United States. That is an active choice that is going to affect, whether you want to think about it or not, is going to affect a lot of people. And it's the same with whoever you're electing, if there's any kind of representative running on the ballot. Anybody that you select is going to have an impact. The mayor of your town is going to have an impact on a lot of people. That is a choice that you are making that is going to impact people. Or wearing a mask, or not wearing a mask. That is a choice. That is a choice that is going to impact you, as if you're not wearing a mask, maybe you don't get to go in a store. Or you get somebody sick. Or you can wear a mask, and maybe you're going to protect people. That's going to impact people. Or it's going to protect you, and that's going to impact people, because maybe there are people who are relying on you. And it's just a chain reaction. And you know, there's a million studies about this. You know, there's the whole butterfly effect of a butterfly flaps its wings in India, and it builds the flap builds up a cloud over Africa, and then that cloud continues, and the wind then picks up in the Gulf of Mexico and creates Hurricane Delta. The butterfly effect. Yes, our choices have chain reactions, and there's a lot of reality to it. The truth of the matter is, do you think about it? Do you think about it when you wake up that morning? When you have the information in your hand, do you think about it? Are you thinking about it right now? That's the question. Do you think about how living rightly, justly, lovingly, mercifully, living a good Christian life, or whatever, you know, moral guidance you follow, when you think about that, do you think about that when you make a choice? That's the question. I mean, I can sit here and say that I know I don't. I know that I don't think about that 24/7. Maybe I should. It's something for me to work on. It's something I want to work on. And I think it's something that I should work on. And I'll tell you right now that it's something that I will work on right now. It's something that moving forward, I want to and will work on. And I hope that you will too. Because our choices, the things that we decide to do, whether it be putting a check mark on a ballot, putting a mask over our face, saying words that need to be said or not, or just, choosing how much spice to put in chili. It all affects people. And it's something that we should all be a little more aware of. It's something that we should look past the 6 inches in front of our face a little more often so that we can care for those around us, so that we can love our neighbors. And in loving our neighbors, we can better love ourselves. And so that's what I want to leave you with this video blog, is that we can do better making the choices that we do, thinking about the choices that we do. I'm not here to tell you what the choice is, right or wrong. I'm just here to tell you that you have an impact on this world, and the choices you make impact those around you. So I hope that tomorrow morning when you wake up, if you see this, you'll go throughout the day making choices maybe just a little bit differently. Or not. Who knows? But blessings to you all. Stay safe, stay healthy. Don't forget to vote. Don't forget to wear your mask. But go out and think about the choices that you're making each and every day.